In this video, I'll take a brief look at two components available in the CampbellCloud Dashboards application, the wind plot and the wind rose. It's important to understand the differences between these two components and the types of applications where a user may want to use a wind plot versus using a wind rose. I'm in the Dashboard Studio. I'll start by dropping a wind rose and a wind plot onto the dashboard canvas. Now I select the wind speed and direction data I want to feed into these two components. I'll choose by measurement classification since I previously defined measurement classifications for the station. I'll select the component options to set the minimum wind speed to 0. The wind rose now shows the new minimum wind speed. Next, I select the wind plot and add the wind speed measurements to the wind plot. Now I select my measurements. I need to define the period of data I want to plot in these components. I'll select the last 6 hours of data. I'll do this for both my wind rose and my wind plot component. Done. I now have the last 6 hours of wind speed and direction data feeding into each of these components. I can immediately tell that although both components use the same data, they present it in different ways. Look at the wind rose. A wind rose presents wind data in a circular format and shows the frequency of winds blowing from different directions over the specified time. In this case, this length of time is configured to be 6 hours. The length of each spoke around the circle is related to the frequency that the wind blows from a particular direction per unit time. Within the wind rose component options, I can configure settings such as the number of direction bins, which determines the number of wind spokes and the angle of a circle covered by each spoke. For example, with 36 direction bins, each spoke covers 10 degrees. I can also configure options such as wind direction visualization. By default, this is set to show where wind is coming from, but a user can change this to show where wind is going to. I can also configure different wind speed bands if I need to. If I were prospecting for a wind farm, I would need to collect bankable wind data over an extended period to prove that a site location is suitable for installing wind turbines. Not only would I want to capture the strength of winds that are expected, but I would also want to capture a clear picture of the prevailing wind patterns. Wind roses are a common method of capturing this information over time. Now look at the wind plot. While the wind plot is using the same data as the wind rose, it's presenting the data in a different way. While the wind rose shows the general direction the wind was blowing from over the selected time, it doesn't show at what time it was blowing from certain directions. This is where the wind plot stands out. In addition to tracking the wind's direction using the arrows, the color and position of the arrows along the y-axis indicate the wind's strength at a given time, allowing you to observe changes in both strength and direction over time. Traffic management centers often need to monitor the wind speed on exposed areas of highway, since high speeds and strong wind gusts can be a significant danger to high-profile vehicles. Bridges and exposed areas are particularly prone to this issue. Due to local geography and topography, the risk often increases when wind blows from a specific direction. In these circumstances, the CampbellCloud wind plot component can be a valuable tool for monitoring wind at such locations. Users can not only visualize real-time changes in wind speed and direction at a specific location, but also set threshold lines on the chart to indicate when wind strength is approaching a dangerous level, prompting actions such as closing a bridge. This, in combination with the alerting tools available in CampbellCloud, allows users to establish comprehensive wind monitoring stations that play a crucial role in enhancing road safety. Thank you for watching.